There you go.
Technology.
There's no shirt. Well, I haven't worn clothes in like 3 days.
Can I cry now? Am I allowed
yes,
to cry?
You can always cry.
Yeah, go ahead.
Okay, thank you.
Giving him permission to cry.
Hello, CJ.
You ever seen a full a big man cry?
Yes, I have personally.
After his friend
myself.
Removes technology from his limbs.
Good.
Yeah.
Better when you were radioactive.
It's called Seven of Nine. She tended to cry when all her Borg implants were removed.
Ayo, Seven of Nine?
Hmm. Oh, damn.
Just kidding. Not many people. You have to be a Trekkie to understand that one, but.
What? Something on my face? No, man. I just have not enough intellect right now for
this. It's all good.
Fucked up cookie.
Oh, hold on, wait.
Later on, after dinner, I'll probably get on back on, and I'll probably be getting drunk again, so we'll see.
Oh my god. Oh damn, what?
It just gets worse.
What are you becoming?
It just gets worse.
Awesome.
Wait a minute. This is the first time me seeing Ether in a different Avi.
A
Rusk.
You're just having fun making blend shapes and blend.
Aww.
Thank you.
Maybe you just go, I pull this stretchy and I make this animation slider in the effects.
Bruh.
And also, rest.
I did not crash. I intentionally left because none of my buttons
worked. Yeah, imagine crashing. Can't be me.
Fair.
No, cringe.
Your butt doesn't work?
Wait, there's another cube Abby that's smaller now?
I had leg day today. You think
I don't know.
Stand up right now?
Nice.
But I like it sometimes when VR chat randomly the audio
it's a baby sheen.
You can't hear nothing.
That's what you're supposed to look like.
It's great.
I just see you used to warp for a while.
I couldn't just barely took off.
Let's see. 10.
Yeah, I thought
nine.
You were
there
as well.
There
it is.
Oh, I did, but cornflakes.
There it is.
I saw that
seven.
Cornflakes was on the phone, so.
There it is.
Six.
Oh my god, there it is.
Five. Four.
There it is.
Three. Seems you have met with an uncertain fate. You find yourself at an interdimensional crossroads, a rendezvous of travelers between worlds. My name is Trajim. I am an actualized post-narrative deathless wanderer and one of the tour guides of VR Travelers. We create immersive, story-based tours with original writing, beautiful worlds, voice acting, and wholesome team effort. Welcome to the Rendezvous, our point of contact to narrative domains. You may notice there is only one fellow tour guide at my side. Apologies for the asymmetry. Sheen is planning on joining us later tonight. PmonNickPop123 is not planning on joining us tonight. But he is here, in spirit. My friends, tonight, we'll be telling the neutral ending of The Prince. You are welcome to stream and or record tonight's event. If you don't already know, due to my upcoming retirement from performing, I am doing one run of each major ending of each of my stories. This is the last time you'll be able to see firsthand the neutral ending of The Prince. Next week, we are due to show both the never-before-seen bad ending A of The Prince and the good ending, the true ending, the ending my friends, we have but two roles. As with any tour in the real world, I politely ask that you remain with me at all times. Secondly, I kindly ask that each time we stop for narration, that you become silent so that the story may continue. However, as we walk from point to point, and during loading screens, you are encouraged to talk amongst yourselves. Now, my friends, feel free to friend us tour guides in case you need to send an invite request to get back into this world, as it will be invite pass. But I am going to drop a portal to tonight's event. Please do not enter the portal until I give the signal that it is clear. I repeat, do not enter the portal until I give the signal that it is clear. Friends and travelers, wait for me in the lobby of the narrative of the prince.
Why growl?
Leg.
Fair.
Where's Eek? Is Eek? What, Eater?
Equal.
Oh, equalization. I don't know. Where's the equalization?
Maybe he's just taking a second.
Loading man, I forgot to load.
Man, imagine. Well, we know all about this tour, don't we? man. I'm just wondering.
One more chance to do.
What? Good. One more chance. Oh! Right, you're trying to record this fully?
Yep.
Okay.
Oh gosh. I've forgotten.
What?
Well, actually, I still have decent frame rate, but like.
So nervous. Sorry.
Slower.
Are you okay?
My GPU died. I need to get her replaced.
Serious?
Oh, I was muted.
Yep.
It's
under warranty, so that should be
why are
fine.
You nervous?
But I just popped in the old
lot of memories. Here.
The old 1080,
just
which is still fantastic, mind you. Still, you know, still a trooper.
There
hello.
You
it's
are.
The 1080. It's time for you to come.
I always
have a
GPU.
Yeah, that's
GPU.
Up way longer than
GPU.
Should have.
I'm just moving you to a new
yeah, you made it.
Mm-hmm.
I mean,
I don't know why it keeps tearing off.
Because I kind of just popped it back in, and it's just...
Yeah, but a lot of tasks...
Yeah, might as well keep it, I guess, at this rate.
I have... Any, also, every
you too, Alzu.
It should be in
Discord, and which is required, turned off.
Yeah, it kind of...
I just had the wrong Wi-Fi.
I was just not even doing anything. I turned on the computer this morning.
Me too.
I turned on the computer.
I want
to
build
like
Betty will be.
It was on for like 30 seconds, and then
she sent me a request to join.
Oh yeah, the next PC I'm getting is definitely.
You gonna make it?
Oh, I can't do that.
I'm pretty sure I
can't do that.
Nothing is like there's no visual signs of any damage. The lights are on. Nothing detects it. Basically.
All their videos.
I generate metal. Dispenser coming.
Hello.
Right, the motherboard's not damaged because
the motherboard's not damaged because
it's good to be here.
It's not the motherboard. It has
to know who you are
because you're
shaders.
Yeah.
I work on IT, so what's the problem with your computer?
Click on anybody.
The 4080
GPU just died.
So you plug it in the slot, turn it on, there's nothing, no pulse, nothing, no beeps.
Computer post. I have CPU has integrated graphics, so it's like I was able to get it going, right? Okay, here's the things that I have tried. Right.
Okay.
I was able to, you know, boot with integrated graphics.
Mm-hmm.
You know, did the whole reset the CMOS stuff. I go into Windows and it's just like no GPU detected. Go into the BIOS, no GPU detected. Lights are on, fans are spinning on the GPU itself.
Mm-hmm.
But I guess the story's starting, so
okay. Later. Okay.
Just
the last time they're doing this specific tool.
Two. One. My friends, gather around so that you can hear me clearly. Allow me to welcome you to the narrative of the prince. Before we begin, aside from the rules from earlier, there are some notes specific to this world. Please listen carefully. Please take a moment to adjust your world volume so that you can clearly hear the distant waves. Please make sure that the button to your left is orange. I repeat, the button to your left should be orange. If you haven't clicked it, that's fine. Tour mode should be on. If you press Tab, or in VR, press the menu button with your right hand above your head, you'll see this world's custom menu. If you need to, you can use the fast travel menu in conjunction with a tour guide's help to catch up with the group.
I can't.
There it goes.
I can't either.
Yeah, you kind of
double tap
really
it. You
got to
raise
your head.
You gotta really raise it.
What am I doing?
It may depend on the scaling of your avatar. Reach for the thunderous skies, my friends. Reach high and well. One last note for VR users. In some parts of the story, this tour has some strong color filters. In some parts. And now, my friends, let us begin. Please, follow me.
Doesn't work.
Yeah, let's go!
Oh, yeah.
Wow. Cool. You can also press Tab on your keyboard even if you're in VR. that doesn't work.
And now, without further ado, the story begins. Say that when I was born, everyone could hear it. The midwives, the guards, the servants, cooks and stable hands, everyone in the castle, everybody in the kingdom. Everybody heard the ocean, but that didn't make any sense. Nowhere near the kingdom. The oracle said it was a sign that I was different. But I never heard the waves myself. At least, not until
I am very blue.
I'm blue.
Funny.
Ah, yes, sleep mode.
Chapter 1. In a castle tower, alone in a dark chamber, a young prince trembles beneath the covers. His brow is furrowed, his breath shallow and rapid. His mind is full, overflowing with grim images, twisted visions, memories of that night. That storm, that harrowing storm, dark waters churning, roiling. Nightmares plague him. Guilt plagues him. Some of the crew members and soldiers were found along the beaches, blue faces strangled by seaweed, bloated. Half buried in grey sands. But his father was not among them. All were lost to the sea. All but the prince. He awakens with a start, saved from the darkness of his own imagination by the comfort of his own bedchamber. But the remission is short-lived. He sits up, looks left at the raindrops sliding down the glass, then right, slowly surveying the dark corners of his chamber. There is a meal on the cabinet, likely cold as stone. The thought of food upsets him, his appetite absent for one or two moons now. With a shaking sigh, he reaches over, scooping up a trinket from his bedside table, and he brings it close, squinting in the low light to make out its details. It is a pendant. A pendant from the sacred land of Ludicia, given to him by his father, the late king. All he has is this pendant, his mother, and his brother. A warmth ignites in his heart, spreading across his body, keeping the cold at bay. Strong, charming, smart, his brother is everything their parents wanted. He even went to battle alongside the Silver Aegis and came back unscathed. The people look up to him. His brother is the king they want. The chill of night begins to win the fight. The pendant loses its allure and his bed pleads for him to return. Heavy covers under which he can hide and wish himself away. A fragile bulwark against a callous, ruthless world that doesn't want him. He dives back down into his refuge and... who would be at his door at this time of night? Is it one of the guard making sure he hasn't fled? Is it the nurse checking up on him again? Is it the zealots finally here to drag him to the tower? Rain batters the glass as he turns his head toward the door. You're still awake? The prince exhales and nods. His brother steps out of shadow, wearing a cloak and carrying a bag. Why is he dressed at this time of night? Has anyone entered your room? The prince looks at him. Have they? He doesn't think so. Aside from the rain and wind, the castle has been quiet. His brother seems nervous, and it makes the prince nervous as well. He shakes his head. Good. The brother glances toward the door. Get dressed. Grab whatever you can carry. The prince's heart sinks. Questions and fears swim in his mind like eels in a bucket of water. Is there a fire? Has Dacia finally reached the capital? Is his mother, the queen, sending him away? Is he finally going to prison for what he did? But none of the questions leave his lips. He just sits there. Listen, his brother approaches the bed. This is serious. Put on your cloak. Take whatever you don't want to leave behind. Someone is after us, and he turns suddenly to face the door. The prince tries to listen. Hurry, the brother says in a harsh whisper. Now! The prince is terrified. He climbs out of the covers and reaches down to open the trunk at the foot of the bed, rummaging for his warmest cloak, the dark blue one with the hood. What about Mother? The prince's voice feels weak, as though it's about to shatter. What about the guards, the Aegis? What about... There's no time! Why is he being like this? The prince finds his cloak, swings it over his shoulders. He slips a long tunic over his nightgown, fastens it with the first belt he grabs, and slips into some boots. He only has time to stuff the Ludician pendant into his pocket before his brother grabs his hand and almost drags him to the door. The brother stops, gestures for the prince to be quiet, and peers out into the passageway. My friends, let us follow the pair into the dark. This way.
Into the dark in the shadow of night.
I heard a rumbling.
Rumbles?
Are you sure that wasn't your stomach? It's a weird sound.
Don't hear that? It's like croaking.
Yeah. Yeah. It's always been a part of the sound, and it's weird. I wonder what it's supposed to be in the original thing. It's...
They also go bite in the night.
Thing? Mark is my bet on any intruder.
His name is Harry. He's a good bet. I like to pet him sometimes.
Whatever.
That's very wholesome.
He eats baseballs.
Harry's a little blind.
He eats baseballs.
In fact, bats aren't actually blind.
This is true. They actually have like, excellent eyesight.
I'm stuck. Why would they have eyes if they were blind?
Okay, that's fair.
Exactly.
I don't know. Ask your local blind person why they haven't removed their eyes.
No, like an entire species.
And the brother pass through an empty hall. The castle has been quiet thus far. But here, from someplace ahead, footsteps come echoing. Quick, behind here, whispers the brother, pressing himself against a pillar. A moment later, a door swings open. The sounds of armor rattling and a woman panting draw nearer. The prince holds breath. The figure staggers past them in a rush, glancing around only briefly, and they exit the way the princes came from. That's the Aegis. The prince's heart flutters, but something's wrong. She looked injured, and how didn't she notice them? The prince peers up at his brother, expecting him to go after his mentor. But he does not. The brother grabs his hand and uses a door on the side. My friends, please follow me.
Ah, yes. This is the traditional traveler's activity of climbing everything in sight.
Indeed. Sounds like a lovely activity.
It's absolutely tradition.
The higher you climb, the further you shall fall. The story continues. Why are we here? The prince asks. The brother hurries past the shelves and moves to the far end of the room, ignoring the question. He starts to check everything, moving random objects, looking behind and under furniture. The prince looks at a nearby open book, some old red tome. Who is after us? The brother stops. The Oracle is dead. The Inquisitor murdered him. He looks the prince directly in the eyes, breathless, afraid. I saw it happen. The Inquisitor saw me. The prince stumbles back, catching himself in a desk. The Oracle dead. The Inquisitor, a cold chill crawls up the back of his neck. A sick feeling boils in his stomach. dead. But the Oracle said that he is the chosen one. The Oracle said that he survived for a reason. The Oracle said he would learn how to control it. He went to Laodicea and found it. The brother steps back and dusts his hands. Help me move this. The two of them carefully, quietly as they can, drag a shelf away from the wall, and behind it, low to the ground, is an old door, a secret passage. This leads outside the castle, the brother says. Are you ready?
Ready? How can he be ready? No. No, this has to be a dream. It feels like a dream, a nightmare. The Oracle can't be dead. Any moment now, he's going to be shaken awake by his nurse. And his mother will be right there, and for once, he will welcome her presence. Yes, it's just a nightmare. Hey. Hey. The brother pulls him back. I know you're afraid. I am too. But without us, Lazarus has no ruler after mother. We're going to escape. We're going to hide. We're going to get help. And then I'm going to figure out a way to solve all of this. All right? It's going to be okay. It'll be okay. The prince can only bring himself to nod before they both crawl into the secret passage. My friends, spoilers, everything will not be okay. Please follow me.
Holy fucking shit.
Let's go.
Oh no!
This isn't a...
Okay, who's doing that sound effect? It's hilarious.
That's great.
Who locked up child?
I didn't.
Don't turn around.
Dear God. A locked up child? No, Lazarus has moved past those days. My friends, the story continues.
Okay.
The brothers emerge from the cramped passageway and find themselves in a dimly lit basement. It seems similar to the kitchen cellars, but the prince doesn't directly recognize it. Judging by his brother's face, he doesn't recognize it either. The brother begins to cross the room slowly, checking every footstep. The prince stops. What's that noise? Grinding, a deep rumbling. The storm returns.
Here we go.
What the?
An image rushes up from the depths, rising to meet him. In a moonlight forest, a beast strides out of the undergrowth. It glides across the ground, argent, majestic, silent. A great silver elk. It lands, pauses, turns back. A younger, tawny elk follows, slower and with less majesty, yet bearing great promise. The great elk observes as the younger elk's shadow moves. It betrays the form. The forest becomes dark. My friends, travelers, You have a choice to make. The prince has four options, four ways that he can react to this vision. Your choices are descend, divulge, dwell, and distract. I will give you 1 minute to discuss what he ought to do. After this time expires, one of you will be called upon to give the best answer you have heard from the group's discussion. Your time starts now.
I think we should divulge.
So, divulge? Something that starts with a D!
So there
you can't drink.
She said that starts with a D. Oh my goodness.
Dance. Deny. Dab.
That's probably gonna be.
Dallas.
Come on, you. We all know that you're stuck here because of Pontain.
No. Daisy. Drive.
Divulge me.
Divert. With a T.
Yeah, but that's what I mean
by
like
not to give away information.
Yeah, it's just a vanilla
yes.
run.
Yeah, it's a reveal. So
divulge
about it.
Oh,
hello there, little one.
Just do the standard thing.
I don't know.
Dine.
I won't.
I don't know if they have any food, but dine. Dine sounds good.
Disease.
Okay.
Is
dying.
Disease a verb?
Defenestrate.
Defenestrate. Oh. There's no window.
Specific ending anyway.
Yeah, that's what it means.
This was establishmentarianism.
Is that a verb?
Or you can, you know, detach.
Maybe.
Detail.
1 minute is up.
That's right.
Drink?
My friends,
drink
attention, what? Please. Your time has expired. The one I am going to call upon is Akaru Tomoe. Do you speak? I see you hiding. You wish to pass this opportunity. Please choose another. Are you pointing at Devi J? Very well, Devi J. I'll make it easy for you, Devi. We're on the path to the neutral ending. So I'll narrow down to the most lore interesting options here. Descend or dwell.
Okay.
Yes.
Dwell. Thank you.
I guess we're all dwellers in one way or another.
Yeah.
True.
The prince allows the vision to occupy his mind. Has he seen this forest before? He doesn't think so. What are the elks, Silver and Tawny? The Aegis who trained his brother is known for her family's emblem of a silver elk. Could it be? His brother is holding the prince's shoulders, family. Another vision? No vision is worth your life. Come on, let's keep moving. We have to stay focused. My friends, the story continues.
Let's fucking go!
We get to see the stuff. Look at this place.
I almost thought I was gonna fall.
Tomb
That's
Raider.
The second time.
Who is stupid fucking Richardson? Apparently there's a.
Right.
Drink it good. You're not in tour mode.
Sorry, what's good?
Uh-oh.
Drink it good. Uh-oh. You must go back to spawn and turn off explore mode. Turn on tour mode. The button must be orange during a tour.
Sure thing.
Rendizzo will help you get back to this point.
Okay.
Use the world's menu. Hold your right hand above your head and press your menu button.
Oh, so this is what happens during explore mode.
Do you see the world's custom menu? You might have to hold your hand higher.
If that doesn't work, you can press tab on your keyboard.
If it doesn't work,
dab
into VR chat and press
that
tab.
Motherfucker.
Yep.
Son of a...
Use the fast travel option to return to spawn. Rendizzo will help you back here once you turn off explore mode.
Sorry, man.
That's right, my friends. In explore mode, you can go anywhere at any time, and during a tour, that may break the sequence of events. But it is a common mistake to happen. No worries, we will wait.
Yep.
It's all good, we got all the time in the world.
Oh, so
I still think the only reason
why do we
I want to braid your hair.
You look like a very polite cat.
You want to what my hair?
Braid it.
Oh, okay.
Braid your hand?
I can't get the menu to pop up.
I'm just not used to like
hair.
Bam.
The thing was orange too. I looked over to my left and
it was orange for me too.
Do you open the menu? No.
Nope. Wait a second.
I also
second.
Like how it's like I can trace it.
What is that up there?
Something new must have broken something.
What happened?
Damn.
Friends, while we wait, I have a riddle for you.
Oh.
Who can answer this question?
Oh.
I'm touching the ceiling.
What is green and white and black and purple?
White, black, and purple.
Oh. And a dead enough body?
The letter Y.
Never mind.
What did he say?
And can only be found in the southern hemisphere.
White,
black, and purple.
I'm making this up as I go. That's right. Rendizzo, I see you back.
Oh my god.
Do we have...
Ah,
yes. Very well, my friends, we are all here. Let us continue. Let me know if you find an answer. I'm pretty sure there isn't one.
Okay.
Damn.
Wow.
I mean, it says white on the inside.
The brother stops the prince as they come out on a high platform overlooking more stone-hewn chambers. The prince listens. There are voices coming. The prince tries to pull away and go back through the door, but his brother drags him down. And they watch and listen as two figures enter, dressed in red garb. You sure we have to search every room down here? Ivana Zealot, with red hair, comes to a stop in the middle of the room. Nobody comes this far. Most don't even know the way. The taller zealot shakes his head. If the Fireborn says to check every room, we're checking every room. Varna, have mercy on you if you want to go against that order. Besides, the Aegis came this way, and he wants to make sure she's on our side. Just as he says this, another door opens, and they both draw their swords. In stumbles the silver Aegis, still clad in shining armor, sword drawn. A moment of tension before they collectively sigh. What happened to you? Asks one of the zealots, sheathing his blade. The prince, he attacked me. So, says the red-haired zealot. It's true then. The prince is an enemy of the church? They both are, the Aegis says. But the younger prince wasn't in his chamber. She begins to look around the room. The prince shrinks down. It seems they're both on the run then, says the tall zealot. The Fireborn was right. Only an enemy of God would attack the most reputable knight in Lazarus. And to murder the Oracle in cold blood? They are demons possessed by Dacian spirits. Come, let us search together. If the princes are so cunning as to get the better of you, he caught me off guard. The Aegis snaps. He didn't seem himself. Still, we'll cover you, in case he tries the same tricks again. The Aegis gives a nod, and the three of them exit, leaving the two princes alone again. They lie there for some moments. The prince wants to turn his head. He wants to see his brother's face. But he also doesn't. After a time, the brother slowly gets up and helps the prince to his feet. They look at one another briefly, wordless, and climb down. My friends, let us follow them. The way out is surely just ahead.
Yeet. Yeet. My avatar is broken.
Yeet.
It's the room with the blizzard sound, even though it's not actually a blizzard.
It's drafty. It's windy.
It's fucking windy.
Yeah.
Windy.
So we are at the
outside.
When did it's supposed to be?
Oh, like, what?
The prince is canonically like 3 inches tall.
Oh yeah.
The prince is canonically 3 inches tall.
Lies and that's propaganda. My friends, the story continues.
What's the propaganda?
Sorry, 4 inches, right?
Chapter 2. A final secret tunnel takes them up some steep stairs and into some long abandoned home. A chilling wind whistles through cracks in the shutters, accompanied by the gentle grey of dawn. The moth-eaten rug breaks apart as the prince makes his way to the old, dust-covered bed. He sits and sighs. He is tired and hungry, and his stomach still churns. The brother goes to the window and peers outside, one hand on the handle of his sidearm. His sidearm was sat there this whole time. The prince wants to ask about it. He wants to ask about the Aegis, the Oracle, the Inquisitor, but his mouth is dry and his jaw is tight, and he, for the first time, is afraid of the only person who has always been there for him. I think it's safe here. Are you all right? His brother is looking at him. The prince nods, and the brother approaches and offers a water skin. Here, he says, have some. The prince looks at it. backs of the leather carved with their own royal emblem. He wants to take it. He wants to trust his brother. He should trust his brother. Shouldn't he? You think I attacked the Aegis? The brother says. You think I killed the Oracle? The prince looks down. Well, says the brother, I did do one of those things. I attacked Aegis. I didn't want to, but you must understand, I had no choice. I saw the Inquisitor with the Oracle last night. I was going to speak with the Oracle about my coronation, but I heard their conversation. I heard what they said about you. I saw the fire in the Inquisitor's eyes. I saw the blood spilling. The Oracle, he had called you Oceanborn. The Inquisitor is... He wields the power of miracles of fire. You know this. He thinks you are sent by the enemy. He thinks the Chosen One should be Fireborn, not Oceanborn. Fireborn, like he is. He... Well, I don't really understand it all, but... What I do know is, if I went to the Aegis for help, then she and everyone else in the castle would have faced the wrath of the Inquisitor, including Mother. So I attacked her. This way, it's just us. This way, everyone else is safe from him. You see it, don't you? You understand? The prince slowly lifts his gaze to meet his brother's. Something about his voice, the way he's talking, he's never heard his brother sound so afraid. He feels the Lodicean pendant in his pocket. Look, the brother says, unbuckling his weapon. If you still don't trust me, take this. Wear it. You be the one to bear the blade. Alright. The prince takes the sword from his brother. Sorry. The brother's stern visage is cracked by a smile. Come on. We need to keep moving, he says. You won't be safe here for long. We need to get out of Moravos, and then I'll figure out what to do next. We'll find allies. Someone who can best the Inquisitor. The brother stands and offers a hand. The prince takes it. And they exit. My friends, let us follow them into the castle town of Moravos and help them find a way out.
Strike up the town.
Oh, yeah.
Yee!
Guys, look!
It sounds like a back in the air.
My life
yes.
is
yeah.
upside down.
Well,
nah.
That sounds like tick tock and the touch grass.
There's a Kahura on my ass.
Huh?
Hello there!
There's a snake in my boot.
He's a Kahura.
My friends gather around and listen carefully.
I ever sees their own tail and thinks it's a snake.
Though the winds howl, the town is slowly waking up, ignorant of what had transpired overnight. Rugs are shaken out of second-story windows. Farmers set up stalls to sell cucumbers, carrots, and cabbage. Smiths stoke their furnaces while innkeepers sweep the past night's chaos out of their front doors. The sun barely manages to break through the clouds. This way, the brother says suddenly, and he pulls the prince aside into some bushes. Not a moment later, a pair of zealots dressed in red approach a pair of city watchmen.
Let it be known, says one of the zealots, that the princes are to be brought before the Viner Church if they are found. They have committed treason of the highest order.
Treason? Truly, what do you speak of?
The heir murdered the oracle and has taken his younger brother as an hostage. The Inquisitor fears the heir is being compromised by the enemy.
The heir? But the heir has faced Dacians on the battlefield. You mean to tell me he...
Queen's orders. If they are found, the Inquisitor must be notified at once. Failure to do so will result in being branded an enemy of the crown and of God.
As you say, we shall spread the word. And the brothers are left alone again. Nobody can know who we are, the brother says. Don't say anything to anyone. Keep your hood up and don't let anyone see your possessions. The guards won't let us out of the gates before checking who we are. We'll definitely be recognized. We just need to get to... Alright, I think I have an idea. I know someone who can help us, but... I need to get across town. The brother looks down the road. My friends, the brothers are about to cross Moravos, but they are going to need your help. Tonight's NPCs, Metal Gen and Moonlight, please come and stand below me and change into your avatars. Travelers, these two members are very important during this quest. Please take a moment to enable their avatars if you haven't already, and keep note of these names. They will be interacting with you.
This avatar is broken for me. Just an error.
Now, NPCs, please go and take your positions in town, but make sure you cannot hear me as I continue the rules. Everyone else, gather close. This quest requires that you are able to use your microphone. If you do not wish to speak, or you think these NPCs know you too well, or you want to opt out of this quest for any other reason, that is completely fine. Please gather behind me in the corner on the boxes if you are opting out. Everyone else, please take a few moments to form pairs and stand in your pairs so that your pairs are clearly visible. Please do so now.
Yay! Let's team up, pack.
Okay.
If you do not have a pair, please come and stand below me. Faron and Aether, are you both pairless?
I know we've paired up
with you. Right there.
Okay, so we've paired up.
You are with Smiles. Is anybody else pairless, my friends? Please stand below me if you lack a pair. Faron and Cillan. Devi and lovely Lulu, you are both a pair. Is anybody else pairless, my friends? Please come and stand below me if you are pairless.
Still looking for a partner.
Okay, you know what?
Reminds me of when I was in school.
Thrilking and Burly, you are a pair.
It's like I didn't have friends.
Yeah, that's good.
All right.
Now, my friends, I ask your attention. There are rules to explain. Your attention, please.
Yes,
Exactly. Excellent.
This is what the NPCs will be doing. They will be roaming the city, and they will question you as pairs, so please stay together as pairs. If they address you, you must answer their questions. No other conversation is allowed between travelers and NPCs during this quest. This is what you will all be doing. You will wander the city of Moravos while staying together in pairs. You may talk amongst yourselves or with other travelers. You may roleplay or be out of character. It matters not. Now, you must all answer the questions as truthfully as you can, except for the secret princes. The princes are a pair who must lie and get away with it. I will choose tonight's princes. Now. Thrill King and Burley. You are the princess.
Gonna be interesting.
You must lie. Do you understand your mission?
Gotcha.
Very well. My friends, you are not making up answers. You are answering questions about your real life, answering truthfully. But the princes are lying. Now, none of you may give any indication whatsoever as to who the princes are. It is up to the NPCs to guess at the end of the quest. You may attempt to hide from the NPCs, but this may come across as more suspicious. So, do so at your own risk. You have 10 minutes to roam the city of Moravos. At the end of this time, you will hear the town bell. Please come and find me at this point. After the bell rings, the NPCs will privately discuss which pair they think were playing as the princes and lying, and your goal is to get away with it. Your 10 minutes starts now. Those who are opting out, please follow me to the end
of
the city.
Guess we'll just wander around.
Let's go. Okay, so
here we just wander around.
Can we tell the truth?
Bolt, you there.
Jeans.
Down here in this nook, you will not be disturbed by the guards. We have a 10-minute break, I suppose.
Technically, down that pit is the VR Traveler's restaurant, McZealots.
You know,
if you survive the fall, you get a good burger.
I'm very tempted to jump down there and get that good burger. How good is it on a scale of 1 to 10?
I haven't tried it, so that's up to you.
I'm gonna ask around. I'm gonna ask the other group members.
minutes remain, friends. 5 minutes remain.
Somebody call
this is the corner.
Where we'll meet up when it's over.
I see.
So you can climb up the walls and be a little shithead.
Down there.
Oh yeah, I'm glad I can't fall down there. That would be so annoying to try to back. Don't accidentally do anything equal. You're just sliding down like
it's a teleport system
character.
Anyways.
So that's where everyone is.
Yeah, we're all gonna
like
let us
one
return.
Scene in Shrek Forever After.
Unless you
want to
explore again, do you
want to
go run around?
Slowly sliding
yeah.
down the
oh, yeah. question
train.
You.
Yes.
Oh, well, now I don't think it's been enough time to question you. But they ran away. They ran away. That's cheating.
I'm sorry. It's not their fault you forgot to take a bath.
Oh yeah, because of the API outage. Just... Yeah. API outages right now. That's why I'm seeing air robots. I'm debating where I should actually friend you or not.
Yeah.
I should keep the gimmick going on.
Just big enough to where everyone has some elbow room.
Oh, never
not so
mind.
Big that
yeah.
it's overbearing. Yeah, this is the end.
I'm gonna let
so,
this like squeeze up for like 2 minutes.
Don't worry
long.
About it.
Just don't want to fall in there, right?
Don't fall in there.
Where did this headache come from?
You cannot fall in there. This map should be fairly accident-proof.
Did you edit it so that we can't stand up there? Oh wait, never mind. You can stand.
Of course I did. This is a quest about being questioned by NPCs. It didn't. It wouldn't make any sense to allow people to climb all over the rooftops. Yes, I put a name in the Nautilus. Don't worry about that.
Well, you just start jumping between rooftops.
I want to do that now. Assassin's Creed
on the rooftop.
Oh dear.
You can also get a headache.
Well, there she
neither.
Is.
Denied.
If you have an eight,
who, me or?
Also,
oh my god.
No.
Are you two part of the same squad?
Burly.
No, we're not.
Burly's
no,
with
no,
me.
No, no, no.
Okay, Burly. Okay, Burly.
Burly's with
Throat
King.
Look at these morons. What is your favorite holiday
Goku
tradition?
God, which is not here. I'm separated.
Let's see. My favorite Halloween tradition is trick-or-treating on Halloween.
Holiday,
like
that works.
Halloween's
Halloween
a holiday.
I like giving.
Started in another kingdom. You're fucking.
I like
terrible.
Giving Christmas gifts.
Yeah.
You, know, if you saw a man stealing candy from a baby. What would you do?
I'd punch the guy.
Okay.
Like, that's just some cartoonish evil.
I'd probably just walk away.
I see.
I do not know how they're climbing.
You
up
good,
there.
Sir? You too afraid to go.
Thank you.
That made me want to climb. That made me want to climb.
I'm not gonna lie, I'm getting more and more tempted to ascend.
Right? Oh my god.
We found the top member of the Assassins, like, order here in Moravos.
Come on, by the power
this
of
is, this is what peak Assassin's Creed looks like.
Yeah, let's see the ship. Damn, it's like I can taste freedom, but...
Yeah, Spider, I've already asked you.
Have
I already asked you, Pac? Pac?
Huh?
Have I already asked you?
No, you ugly-ass guard with your shitty-ass armor.
No, you ugly ass spider with your ugly ass spider. Alright, question. What last genre of music did you willingly listen to?
What? Rephrase that? What was that?
The last genre of music you listened to, willingly.
Oh, so something I wouldn't like?
No, something you would like, but you chose to listen to the genre.
Oh, wait, okay. What was the last thing I listened to? Where's my... I can't remember.
Either of you can provide an answer.
Gahor, what's the last thing you listen to? Gahor, you got your Spotify up?
Yeah. I was listening to What Was I Made For by Billie Eilish. Because I like depressing music, apparently.
So that's
depressing pop. Got it. And Pack?
Yeah.
Mm.
Yeah, what, you know, I do like emotional bullshit.
Fair enough.
Things that make me want, you know, to die or something.
Okay, moving on
next
from
question.
That. What's your favorite holiday dish? Happier question.
Favorite holiday dish?
Yes.
Oh my god. I like green
bean
casserole.
If you
want to
be clear, you can choose your favorite design of a plate.
My favorite design of a plate? Paper?
Question to all
paper.
The groups. Every
I
question
only like
all the groups.
Because I love Vietnamese food.
I think so. Unless
you like what?
Some,
all I heard
like,
was Cajun
base. I can check real quick.
I said I like.
Like I haven't
that's
questioned
right.
These
we're about
two.
To finish.
Never had
to eat Trajan.
I still can't hear you.
I said I like pho.
Pho. Okay, for the holidays.
Yeah.
Okay.
Why don't you go out to a Vietnamese restaurant and order food from there and just take it home? That's what I do.
Oh, fuck.
You know, I can respect that. Question over. Thank you.
Yes.
What's your favorite holiday tradition?
I hate the Christmas
I'm
music.
I'm just updating a friend right now.
But I love giving things to people and friends.
My favorite holiday...
I guess
tradition.
We've explored everywhere.
Tradition.
And time should be ending soon. I guess we'll just hang here.
Is stalking the innocents on Halloween.
You can show your avatar. Stuck. Oh well, there you go.
Quick.
See you later, slut lord.
Just real quick. What would you do if you saw a man steal candy from a baby?
Babies are so fucking
guys, I'm stuck in here.
Hello,
congratulations.
Pack scares me.
I'm in this little box.
You think?
Last case of emotion. How sad.
In a few minutes, that won't be a problem.
Wait. Grab onto Pack Lover's booty and then get out of there.
So, fun fact, I helped make some
he's gone.
And this place is crowded.
It's true, my ass is gravel.
Yeah.
What, like writing?
Mm-hmm.
Or something.
Very cramped.
Yay!
Don't change avatars.
You get used to it.
Grandma.
Inside the wall. You're inside the wall.
Friends and travelers, please gather around where you can hear me while the NPCs discuss who they think the princes are. I just need to make sure that, yes, all right, they're discussing. While we let them talk, there is currently a major API outage with VRChat. Rindizo is trying to rejoin, and Sheen is also trying to join. For now, it's just me, so I ask your forgiveness as I run this ship alone for a short while.
Oh no.
We should make things different.
Oh no, 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 no.
Okay.
Back, that was the most redundant thing you've
ever
said.
I made
a couple
characters.
Okay. If they have access to NordVPN, they're gonna have to split servers.
Isn't that the first time this happened?
Oh my. This is a mutiny of VRT. Trajum is heavily outnumbered now. We can take him.
What?
Are you kidding me?
They
don't call him Solo Jim for nothing.
Finally
the man
the
solos.
Get him. Drake.
You'll finally open that door.
I'm sorry. What did you say to me?
Oh no! You upset Trajan, the Holy Cube.
With all of our lives.
I very much like my life. Please don't make them take it.
I'm my own master. There, I can take.
I have a pie.
That's a
really good 2D image of a pie.
The tour guides give, and the tour guides taketh away.
Ooh.
Oh god. Oh, that's intimidating.
Look back, Clover. I can see the sky from here.
It's cloudy.
This is an intense deliberation.
They're taking a while.
Very cloudy. That's a very cloudy
I gave them a few extra minutes to question everyone since we were having technical difficulties. And we are almost at the halfway point. There is a break coming up, friends. Fear not.
Yeah. Little pickle.
Oh, my neck. What do you think, Pack Lover? Were we being suspicious out there?
I think I was acting normal. I'm so
I
normal.
Can't support this big ass canceled
neck.
Afraid I must force you into
You're letting Steve leak.
What?
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 Don't worry about
the
it.
Phrasing?
Leaking.
Don't worry about it.
And down it goes.
The urge to just stomp anyone who goes on the floor.
Masculine urge to curse somebody.
That's I don't know why I did that. I just. You understand?
Is he a Pokemon?
Welcome to Ether.
Can't tell.
Yep. Ooh, I don't think I see any Pokemans.
The NPCs are moments from making the decision.
The cookie has crumbled.
Does that mean you threatened them?
The crumble has cookied.
Yes.
Well, that wasn't really the cookie at all.
VR chat
it melted.
Had to like freaking dump its shit.
It could be a nicely
it's
baked chocolate
API.
You
chip.
You see
them? The cookie is clicked.
Did they hear somewhere? Out. Point them out.
Yes, I see them.
We need to do
in
the back.
My friends, not yet, friends, not yet. The quest has come to a close. Everyone, please, listen carefully. NPCs, Metal Gen, Moonlight, which pair do you think
were the princes tonight?
We believe it was Devil and lovely Lulu.
Oh no.
Devi, Jay, and lovely Lulu, please come forth. Stand before us.
They were a group of three?
Now, my friends, using interpretive dance, give a response. Are you the princes? The most beautiful dance I've ever seen, and the most denying dance. NPCs. Behold, the real princes, please come forth. That's right, Thrill King and Burly.
I did not suspect them.
Masters of deception.
Yay!
Very well, my friends. The quest is concluded, and the story continues.
Yes. Something happened if they were found out.
As he walks across Moravos, the prince tries to shrink back into his cloak. His brother strides ahead, swift and confident. How does he do it? Every Moravian looks at them, stares at them. Do they know? Do they know who they are? Suddenly, he bumps into his brother as he comes to an abrupt stop on a bridge. He looks past his brother. A city watchman is talking to an elderly couple on the other side. The guard's back is to them. The brother backs up and guides them another way. The prince glances back at the old couple. He can see the old woman looking at him. She points the guard in the opposite direction. He offers her a smile. A short while later, the prince stops. What's that? What's that noise? A grinding, a deep rumbling.
Here we go.
An image rushes up from the depths, rising to meet him. Amidst vague, towering structures, a blue bird flits, darting from corner to corner, desperate. In pursuit is a red feline, stalking calmly, yet appearing in places where it should not be. The bird is frantic, its movements urgent and panicked. It tries to stay silent, yet every beat of its wings betrays its location. And everything begins to glow red. My friends, you have a choice to make. The prince has four options, four ways to respond to this vision. Descend, divulge, dwell, and distract. I will give you 1 minute to discuss what he should do. After this time expires, one of you will be called upon to give the best answer you have heard from the group.
Drain.
Drain.
Well,
so basically,
dance.
what would have happened if the princes were caught? Because we wouldn't get
this drive.
They would have been chased off before the prince could have this
vision. Dean, correction. Actually, we still got Dingle because the princes were caught once.
Dingle.
A different set of dialogue.
I thought we didn't get the vision.
No, we got the vision. Trajan, can you confirm? Did we get the vision or not?
Did you get the what?
Damn.
The vision. What do we lose with the game?
Do we still get the vision?
Yeah, yeah. If the princes are caught, do we get the vision?
During that quest? No, you don't.
Direct.
Oh, fair enough. He's right. Never mind.
My friend, I'm hopping back to spawn since there is no one here to help me get new members here. I'll share the tone shortly.
Okay.
Will the chaos commence?
Okay, now. Everyone needs to take on the stupidest pose they can.
I gotta remember
those.
I can't remember the fourth one, actually.
Was one of the options dwell?
Yes, Kahora.
Distract.
I want to be part of your pack and be loved.
Deeper.
Okay. You're already a traveler.
Boop.
Derp.
DP.
Man.
You must die.
DPS.
Yes.
Let
me slow.
Yes.
Nom.
No.
Oh, hi, Trajan.
Why are you back?
You are looking like a snake.
Red.
Oh, wait. I
not.
Like
I'm Trajan. My friends, your time has expired.
Oh, my.
I will now call upon Opus Nix. Greetings. What is the best answer you have heard from the group? Descend, divulge, dwell, distract.
I like that. I'm not. This is my first time here.
Apologies, can you repeat that?
Distract.
Ooh. Distract.
Interesting.
The prince tries to shift his focus elsewhere. The visions bring nothing but misfortune and suffering. He reaches into his pocket and finds the Ludician pendant. And grips it. Someday, this will all end, he tells himself. Everything will be okay.
Oh, fancy.
Hey, are you all right? The brother is holding the prince's shoulders firmly. More visions. You know you shouldn't let them get to you so much. You need your strength. We're almost... The brother stops. He yanks the prince down behind a stone fence. I saw him. The Inquisitor. Didn't see us, I think. All right. I think he's gone. This way. I know someone who might be able to help.
brother takes the prince to a nearby house, checks the street, then knocks on the door. Moments later, the door creaks ajar, and an elderly man peers out. He says but one word. You. And he glances beyond them, his expression gray. The prince shrinks back. How bold that you would show up on my doorstep. His mouth twists and he sniffs once. I had a feeling you might appear. Then the wrinkles on his face deepen into a smile. He opens the door wide and invites them in. My friends, let's follow them inside.
Trajan loves his bell.
This is the temptation.
Oh, bum.
Oh, Valentine.
Oh, Val, you suck.
Yes.
One of Trajan's other tours that unfortunately is over now, I will say, took place in a Ghost in the Shell world.
I am mad. I'm sad.
There are gods of the tours if you want to watch them.
Soup?
Do not be sad.
Oh,
soup is
cool.
Later.
Yeah. A few people here archive the tours.
I'll put you in charge.
Yes.
Ooh.
Oh, Tech Nerd especially is improv the tour for you.
Very British.
Stepping off a late night.
Old paintings sit crooked upon the walls. And cobwebs collect dust in the corners. But this home is sturdy, and the cold is kept at bay, and the prince feels a little more at ease. The old man makes his way to a stall with the help of his cane. The prince notices a glimmering sword displayed on the mantel above the fireplace. Come. The old man says, holding up a jug. You must be thirsty. The brother accepts a cup. This is wine, he says. Of course, it'll ease your troubles. Go on. The brother takes a sip, as does the prince. It tastes bad. It bites at the tongue. But there's a hint of fruit. The old man drinks straight from the jug. So, he says, I suppose you're here to tell me the full story. You've heard from the zealots, then? Asks the brother. You think a retired veteran like me gets his information from a single source? I've heard them say that you murdered the Oracle and fought your way out of the castle. I heard them say you attacked the Silver Aegis, but that's not true at all, is it? Actually, the brother looks down into his wine. The Oracle is dead, but it wasn't me, or my brother, and I did attack the Aegis. I had to. The veteran has another swig of wine, swills it, and regards the brother with a long look. Mm-hmm. Well, you know what's going to happen next, don't you? Once word gets out that both royal heirs are missing, traitors or no, Dacia is going to advance again. They're cunning. They'll take advantage of this predicament, just like they did at Lakeford, where this all started. I'll wager it won't be long till they take Felden. That place has been a pit since the Baron was killed, what, a decade ago? And I hear they've already started infiltrating those old walls. Dacia.
his knuckles turn white. But we can't go back to the castle. The Inquisitor is too powerful. He's gone mad. So you want me to face him? Huh. Young sire, I may have been the best swordsman in Elazareth in my day, but with all due respect, that is madness. You haven't read The Crimson Vanguard? That man is capable of terrifying things. Then, the brother glances at the prince. What do we do? Who can help us? Who else is there? The smile gently leaves the veteran's face. Best I can do, young sires, is get you out of these walls, out of the city. He gets up using his cane, making his way across the dusty stone floor. Back during your grandfather's reign, we had tunnels built beneath Moravos. Most were narrow and used for emergencies, but some were large enough that where there were houses built down there, cut into the stone. Given that you're here, it seems you used one to escape. But there are many more. I'm likely the last one alive who knows where every entrance can be found. And, of course, what sort of tactician would I be without my own personal escape? Help me move this, would you? The brothers assist, and behind a wooden cabinet is an old door. This leads to the underworks, the veteran says. There may be others down there looking for you, but it's dark. You should be able to just leave. Cross the cistern and you'll come out near the Eastern Road. My thanks. The brother opens the door and guides the prince in before him. And I'm sorry. Sorry? Nonsense, it'll take much more than a strike from you to slow her down. I don't mean for her. The brother grabs the cane from the veteran and strikes him across the legs with it. The old man cries out and topples backwards, and the brother pulls the cabinet back in place behind him. My friends, follow me.
Brother fucked up that old man.
Yeah.
I wish you didn't tell me that Ghost in the Shell thing was cool, because now I'm just distracted thinking about it. You should have told me at the end.
Oh no.
Oh,
I'm sorry.
Rad, it was rad.
Oh. That was weird. I spawned right behind the door.
I didn't mean
off.
To take away from this one.
Yeah, that happened to me right now.
I mean, it's really good, this one.
Oh. Oh, no. Wait.
The air down here is musty.
Caution.
Stifling. Somewhere in the distance, water trickles and dribbles. Rodents dance along the remnants of what look to be underground buildings. What is this place? Why is there a city beneath the city? Faint patches of light leaking through from somewhere above reveal the path ahead. I'm sorry you had to see that. The brother says. The prince can't make out his face in the low light. The Inquisitor has to think we forced our way in. I just... But he doesn't finish. He begins to walk. My friends, this way.
Sheen Ouija has joined my instance.
Yeah.
God. Is funky here.
Let's just go through and wait for me on the other side. Oh, go right. Through, friends. Okay, no, wait for me on the next map.
Okay, you know what?
No, please click the door and wait for me on the next map.
Damn you! You got God. It! You got it! Come on!
Damn it!
Come on, you can do it! Let's go!
There we go.
You get at this.
Come on!
No.
Jump! Jump like.
Are you skateboarding? Ouija boarding sounds fun if you don't know what it actually is.
I'm
so glad that you could make it.
Is it like surfing but on top of Waluigi?
Tell you what, see if you can read up to so that it overlaps mine.
Oh shit, Sheen's here.
Yeah, she's and then here. We can have
what
both.
Is your
they,
favorite
like,
holiday?
Get closer, get closer, yeah. Get closer.
Are we underground?
Big head, aren't you?
No. Not
there we go.
It's a castle.
My
me, yeah.
There it is.
Tradition. I don't know if
it's a oh, you
yeah.
Got these now. Nice.
I will say
no, he does.
That.
We are just combining our powers.
I have leveled up.
My favorite,
to camp.
I don't think I have. Oh, yeah. My favorite
yes.
Holiday tradition because my grandmother's German.
No,
my grandmother's German. They do gift opening on Christmas Eve. Putting all the gifts on Christmas Eve night.
Nah. Let's gather around the campfire and
oh,
sing our campfire song.
A
C-A-M-P-F-I-R-E-S-O-N-D song. And if you don't think that you can sing it faster than your wrong player, it will help it. You just sing along. Bum, bum, bum. C-A-M-P-F-I-R-E-S-O-N-D song. C-A-M-P-F-I-R-E-S-O-N-D song. And if you don't think that you can sing it faster than your wrong player, it will help it if you just sing along.
The cream corn that my cousin makes every time we have a holiday get together.
My friends, attention, please. My friends, your attention, please. At this point in the story, we have a designated break. Please, if you need it, have a snack, rehydrate, and use the restrooms if you need to, or there are bushes over there. Please be back here for the story to continue in 4 minutes.
This dictator always trying to tell us what to do.
4 minutes, my friends.
Bullshit. Some water.
Yep. Okay, alright. Do we have soup?
I just made it.
It's a corn that's got like other things that make it where the corn is basically almost in like a really somewhat
dear chat.
Okay, alright.
Not that's letting you get in for a moment. Reserve the down for soup.
I always feel halfway plate of that thing.
Yes,
and do that twice. Basically, give myself an entire plate.
That's
me, my mom, squash casserole.
I did not ask for much.
Audio problems, my old friend. I've come to sit with you again. I live, not as a cube, but as a series of tubes made to look like planes. Yes, the internet in disguise.
It's a series of two. Alright, who has soup?
Oh,
does anyone have soup?
Those are really good biscuits.
Yeah, don't worry, I've been there. Alright, who has soup?
So,
no one
has
soup.
Soup. The internet
soup.
Goes
soup.
To the
soup.
Water.
Soup,
yes, just as they are.
Sip, Oh my god, I'm tasting
now. Now to the melody of
the precious soup.
It's too fast. Too much soup for me.
I mean, I see her
Arms, really.
Oh.
The VRC outage is not affecting users that are already in VR. It's trying to log out.
Mine has marshmallows.
Imagine saying soup in the Soviet national anthem.
Yeah, it's not ill. You can tell them that it's an outage when the VRC starts.
Yeah, the API is not.
I'm surprised too. I'm part of two groups that have a soup meme, and I have
regret saying that because I've given the idea.
The outage is also reported.
Had the idea.
The US, but it seems the EU is okay.
Yes, the one is the designated soup.
Yeah, but excuse me.
Okay, so I have. I have. Okay, I have. I'm gonna need to, like, make a picture of this. Because I have, like, a soup texture.
You have a what now?
Oh, shoot, dream soup. Dream soup is pretty good.
These beers are massive. It's the size of a baseball.
So
yeah, I have
like
a perfect soup, dream soup, and meatball soup.
The soup slime?
Okay. I'll post a picture to the Discord later.
Man.
Yes, a slime that is made out of soup.
I need traveler's soup.
Yeah,
I
want to
Soviet national anthem.
One of the tall guys in there
is really good. It's not your soup, it's
your soup. The right here, you like spaghetti.
Just like sheen on the front of the can.
Well, I think
yes.
It's,
yes, we need to make this. Yes.
I got some pepper jack spice. You know, I was looking at a panda earlier, and he had like full body tracking technology. He had legs, he had a spine, he had hips, the whole nine yards.
My question sometimes while I'm still in the palace Discord server sometimes, I basically never go anymore on account of often being at the same time as VRT.
Wouldn't it be so crazy if Pan opened his one powerful game and crawled out of him?
VR chat.
Yeah, with the dog.
Yeah, I'm trying to
friends and travelers. I ask for your attention. Friends and travelers, please give me your attention. Gather around, my friends. The story continues. Chapter 3. It's after sundown by the time the brothers emerge. The Underworks tunnel led them into an old mill, and from there they followed trails until coming upon the eastern road. Moravos looms in the distance, gently glowing in the moonlight, as the prince slumps to the ground.
His legs and feet ache. His stomach growls. He's tired. He's sore. He's short on breath. His brother is just looking through a bag he's carrying. How does he do that? How does he just keep going? Can't we go back? The prince bites his lip. He didn't mean to say that aloud. Go back? The brother lifts his head. An owl hoots nearby. Go back and what? Face the Fireborn? He'll kill you, and then he'll lock me away or kill me as well. He'll tell everyone that the Oracle chose him, and nobody can disagree. The Varna Church will change forever. Mother will be powerless to stop him, and then... And then Daisha will invade, and the people will have to live under the rule of one of two monsters. We're not going back. Not until I find a way to stop the Inquisitor. And while I search, I'm going to stop the Dacians. We'll go to Felden. We'll warn them of the Dacians. We'll help defend the town. I'll kill every Dacian if I have to. We can still make a difference. I won't have another lake for it. Do you hear me? We still... Stop. Stop. Things. Please stop. Sorry. I'm sorry. I just... It's just you and me. There's nobody else now. It's just us. Listen. His brother squats before him. I'm frightening you. I see that. I don't like to see you afraid. But I'm doing what must be done. Do you remember when we were little? We found that nest in the old tower. We spotted the mother, a blue wing, coming back to feed her chicks that evening. We named them, too. Dusty, Scylla, and... Pickle. Pickle, yes. Little Pickle. And then the cat found the nest. The mother bird. But you asked me why that happened. Do you remember what I told you? Varna is kind. Life is cruel. That's right. Right now, two little birds have to leave the nest. The cat is after them. If the birds aren't in the nest, then the mother can fly to safety and the cat can't reach her. But this cat is sly. It's going to try to trick the other animals into helping it. So the little birds might have to do some things that seem bad so that they don't get eaten. They have to, well, learn to fly, perhaps, or find another cat who'll help them. The prince nods slowly. He can see how hard it is for his brother. He doesn't want to do the things he's doing. He has to. They need to survive. He wants to reach out for his brother. He wants to hug him, but he cannot bring himself to move. The brother stands. We can go through the Duke's Weald. It will be dangerous, but it's the fastest way to Felden. Do you still have my... The brother stops and looks down. The prince is hugging him tightly. It's all right. Look, when this is over, we can sail to Ludicia, the sacred lands. We'll go together. Just you and me. Would you like that? The prince wipes his face. Ludicia? Really? Do you swear it? The brother smiles, and the world gets a little brighter. I swear. My friends, the brothers have a perilous task ahead. They must cross the Duke's Weald in the dark of night. They are going to need your help. This way.
Oh.
Yes.
Well.
Smooth.
Now into the dark, dark forest, in the dark, dark woods, there are some dark,
well,
dark
nice
trees, and in the dark, dark trees, there's a dark, dark
forest.
There
are some dark,
dark,
dark monsters along with
oh,
our dark,
you
dark
spoiled
personalities.
It. Oh, you spoiled it, I was getting there.
The delicious
I
ginger
I
smooch.
Gonna get. How about I give you a dark, dark burger with that?
Where's my kiss?
Dark
oh.
Fries?
Yes, with extra dark fries.
Yeah.
Hell yeah.
They're
yeah.
Burnt so- with the- they are burnt so fries. That's why they're called extra dark fries.
Well, you know what, carbon is good for the bones. Give me that check.
Are you sure you didn't just burn the fries?
It doesn't work like steel, my man.
What is that growl?
I think that is.
Would you say that?
That growl is the phantom of the Duke's Weald Forest. NPCs, Metal Gen, and Moonlight, please come forth.
Geez, the phantom sounds a lot like Panda.
NPCs, please change into your avatars now. Everyone else, please make sure you have the avatars of Moonlight and Metal Gen still shown.
Oh my god, it's a furry!
Tree audio. Oh no, it's a furry! Oh my god!
Can you describe the furry to me because I can't see.
Oh my god!
It's a black dragon.
Yeah. It's a what?
Emotional damage!
Isn't there like
oh,
a furry decree going on?
Wait, what?
A what?
NPCs, Moonlight and Metal, go through and prepare. Everyone else, please remain here.
Dang it. Metal Torture is something
yes.
I can see.
VR chat. Blue and tape.
I think we're gonna get chased by Moonlight. What about you all?
Yeah, that's what I'm thinking.
My friends,
yeah.
The Duke's Weald at night is not a safe haven, but it does bear resources that they may need on their journey. The rules for your second quest are as follows. Navigate your way through the Duke's Weald, which, according to legend, is haunted. Collect as many resources as you can. Each traveler, each of you, has 5 bundles of wood and 5 clusters of berries to locate. You must avoid the Duke's Weald Phantom. Its terror will render you immobile for several seconds, costing you your valuable time. The Phantom can teleport to any Phantom Flame at any point in time, so stay alert. You are being observed. For this quest, please avoid using avatars that are under or oversized or invisible. Once you have completed your mission, you can either make your way to the end where I will be waiting for you, or stay behind to act as a distraction for the Phantom. Please, do not use teleportation shortcuts while partaking in this quest. After your 5-minute timer expires, all remaining resources will disappear, and you will be escorted to the end. The NPCs are ready. Now. Not yet. Please step away from the entrance. The teleport is automatic. Oh. Please wait here.
Oh, the teleport is automatic.
Yeah. Well, it's just a. That's well, when Trajan presses the invisible.
My friend, your
right
5 minutes starts now.
Where do we go?
I immediately get lost in the foliage.
A bundle of sticks I found.
Berries. Equal.
There you are. We got scavenged.
Oh,
go.
So now I know what the sticks look like. The berries are very noticeable. They're just big ass blueberries.
Oh, no. Terrifying at all.
There's a phantom.
My giblets!
Ah, the phantom! Oh, you got.
I got. Oh. Where the berries at? In the bushes.
Nice. Berry.
Okay, I'm back.
I wanna be a witch!
There's a berries here. Right here.
One point right there. Yay! Stand, like, right next to
excuse
the
me, coming through. Beep beep.
Pack, you look like a witch.
Oh, I saw something.
Oh, boy. Oh no!
Oh,
I'm dying!
We got caught.
There's a wood over here. There's a wood right here. Here's another wood.
Oh, God.
I love wood. Now I just need more berries. Got all my woods. Where are the berries at? Let me play with your berries. I'm just trying to find the last bits of wood.
On. Oh.
Where else do I go?
Wait, oh, I found some wood!
Yeah,
right here.
That's my fifth wood. I just need to find the last bundle of berries in the next minute.
You got this, guys.
Oh, goodness gracious. I'm just going in a circle.
I need a fucking bear.
Nope, not that way.
I'll run.
There's some berries. I found some more berries. I just need one more berries. One more berries.
It might be over here. Look up, look up, look up, look up.
Still can't find that.
Yeah, there you go.
Berries are up here, too. Up here.
Damn it, I'm missing one of each.
Okay.
Shoot. Well, I don't remember what the solution was for this.
We're stuck. What the heck?
This A group, you collected an average of 8.2 resources.
Stuck slow.
And now, with those results, the story continues.
I'm stuck slow. I can't move any faster.
If you are slow, you must rejoin the world. A tour guide will help you back here.
Good.
The brothers come to a clearing. A steep river cuts through the middle of it.
Chapter do we need to go to?
I have no idea, but I can't get the
chapter 4. I believe
four?
If we go to chapter 3.
I can't get the menu. I cannot get the menu. I cannot get the menu.
So four?
Before you go, let's go together. Just a moment.
I can't get the menu.
Uh-oh, it's not working for you. I'm not sure why, tech nerd.
Yeah, I had to use a tab on the keyboard.
While you're checking that, I'm going to click chapter 4 just to make sure the path works. Be right back. And then, use the back buttons to go back. Mm-hmm. Click chapter 4 now, and I'll take you there. Hello there. Use the tab menu to go to chapter 4. And then go back, not forward, in order to catch up to the group.
Tab doesn't work for me either.
Confirm that's the right way to go.
Which button do I press? Because that's not working for me at all. Tab does not work.
Try raising the controls, not so much in front of you, but a little bit next to your head. But still up, facing upward. And when you look in front of you directly, you do not see a menu appear, is that correct?
Finally. Okay. Backwards?
The back button is right here. Over here, where it says leave Felden.
Divulge.
That's already an option.
Or not the memory.
Yes, I want to do that one. I don't know what that means.
Divulge. You haven't seen
I did.
But I also want to
distract. And travel. The time.
Blithe bandit, you have been chosen. Do you speak?
Trying to unmute.
Sure, they're trying to unmute or they're trying to type.
I think they're typing.
Yeah, that's a type motion.
He's letting it, we're in the same room. He's saying descend.
Saying descend.
Yeah.
Very well.
Oh yeah.
Thank there. You for using Curtis Nix as your speaking vessel.
Sorry.
It thumbs up.
Established.
The translator.
Yes. The prince dives deeper into the vision. He watches the shadow close in on the walls. They don't seem aware of it at all. And draws closer and closer. Ever silent, ever dark, until it reaches the pack and becomes one of them. The shadow joins the pack and they seem oblivious. The wolves continue to hunt with the intruder in their midst, and before long, they are over the next hill, leaving the prince alone. Wake up, come on. The prince is shaken awake. The sky is a soft blue-gray. The brother is crouched over him, looking somewhere else. There are voices nearby. The prince rubs his eyes and turns to... Across the river are soldiers in black, carrying spears and swords with foreign emblems on their shields. They're pushing a cart through a clearing. Patience, the brother whispers, gritting his teeth. The veterans said they might be here. Either they're preparing to besiege Felden or they've already taken it. Maybe I can find their camp. Find their general. He looks down at the prince. And his expression softens. Let's get a closer look. We need to see what they're up to. They gather their things, scoop dirt over the charcoal, and carefully make their way across the river to the other side of the clearing. My friends, Dacians are dangerously close. This way.
Yeah.
We proceed.
Go, pack, go!
Metal, please.
Yes.
Oh. Are these ruins?
You want more? You're saying,
that
please.
Asking for more.
It looks pretty ruined to me.
That was bad.
I know.
That was a dad joke and a half.
Dad joke? No, more like
a dad joke and a half?
I'm disappointed in both of you.
Do you want to tell me a daddy joke?
Hide in the undergrowth. The outer walls of Felden loom over the treetops, scarred by past battles, defaced by nature. There is a large gathering of Dacian soldiers just outside the small gate, bringing supplies inside. So, Felden has already been taken by Dacia. Maybe they were already here and didn't need any distractions. There are too many of them, the brother whispers. But maybe I can. The brother creeps forward. One step. Two steps, lifting himself a little higher. The prince's heart jumps. Is he going to run in and fight them? How can they not see him right now? When the gate is clear, run inside and hide in the town. I'll find you. What? I'm going to draw them away. Are you ready? I think so. The brother turns back to the Dacians. There are at least 7 of them left after the rest went inside with the handcart. A brother scoops up a fist-sized rock into one hand. They wait. And they wait. without warning, the brother jumps to his feet and breaks into a sprint. He ditches the rock at a soldier and strikes him square in the helmet. There's a cry, then yelling, and they call him names the prince has never heard before. The brother runs to the left, diving between the trees, moving parallel to Felden's outer wall. Five soldiers give chase. Two remain, hesitant to follow. They both draw their swords, staring in the direction everyone else went. Wait a minute. Sword. His brother's sword. He might, I need it. But it's too late. He unsheathes it just in case. Even in the dull light of dawn, its golden gilding glints. Who's there? The prince looks up. The two soldiers are coming his way. He must have made some noise. He freezes and holds his breath. His blood begins to drain from the top of his body. His legs go numb. No. Turn away. Turn around. Lose interest. Go away. Leave me alone. Please. 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 Hey, there's someone in the trees. The prince scrambles into a sprint away from them. He hears Dacians yelling after him, thudding through the underbrush. Go away, stop following me. Around a tree, under a log, over a rock, through tall grass. Are they getting closer or further away? He cannot tell. He can hear their boots pounding the ground, their swords slashing through low-hanging branches. He can hear their heavy breaths. He can feel it on the back of his neck. No, 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 leave me alone. He keeps running and slips suddenly on muddy ground, and then the ground vanishes, and the forest rises up, careening overhead as he topples. Topples into ice-cold waters.
Hello again.
Metal, that was Kahora.
Well, I thought it was.
Kahora.
Okay. Again.
What are we talking about? What happened?
What about Kahora?
He Kahora said it was a daddy joke.
Oh my god.
My friends, your attention, please. The story continues.
Yay.
Chapter 4. The prince comes to. Something is pulling on his leg. He opens his eyes to see a mangy dog trying to drag him by the ankle. He panics and kicks, and, not expecting retaliation, it darts away with a yelp. The prince takes in his surroundings. He's inside a town, right by the water's edge, utterly soaked. He shivers and sits up. Everything hurts. He looks up, 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 up at the town's structures and... Wait, the sword. Where is his brother's sword? He looks left and right into the water. It's not here. He gets to his feet. And with nowhere else to go, he heads into the town of Felden. This way, friends.
We go.
Yay.
to him?
Oh, that was probably just a groan.
Mm-hmm.
I thought someone passed wind, I'm sorry.
One moment, friends, stragglers.
No worries.
Stragglers!
Thank you, everyone.
Ow.
The prince hears a commotion ahead. There's a line of people with wooden balls outside a door. Within, he can see Dacian soldiers giving out the same amount of food to each person. Next in line is an old lady who can barely place one foot before the other.
Please, kind sirs, if I may, I would like a little more than usual. My dear canine friend, his name is Riot, you see. He's going hungry. He's all skin and bones. Please, sirs.
That's not fair, says a townsman right behind her. Why does she get more? Peace, peace, orders the soldier. He regards the elderly woman carefully. Fine, have extra, but just this once.
Oh, bless you. Vana, bless you.
And here, the soldier adds, offering a wooden stick. Seems like you're having trouble walking. The elderly woman is overcome. The prince turns away, wanting to distance himself from this scene. These are just normal people, he says to himself quietly. I didn't do anything wrong. As he hurries away, he bumps into a group of strangers. He mutters an apology and goes to move around them, but they block his exit. He peers up at them carefully. Those faces. Well, look who we have here. Zealots. The prince feels panic bubble up inside him. He wants to shout for help, but there are so many people about. Dacians might help the zealots. A fight might break out. Innocent people will get hurt. No. No, there's too much risk. Calm now, lad. No more running. My friends, the prince has no choice. This way.
Now let's see, it should be right about.
Wait, do that again.
Are you getting bigger each time? I feel like you're slowly growing.
He's a growing boy.
Huh? Do I have an
avatar hidden that's keeping me from seeing something?
CJB.
Do you see the cookie?
Oh. No, I don't.
The zealots lead the prince down some old rock-hewn steps and through another door, and the passage opens up to a large and dark room. Carved niches hold sickly green candles, and many figures in red stand near the corners, watching silently. Fireborn, says one of the zealots, we have the prince. A shadow that the prince didn't see until just now turns. It is a titan of a man with a broad chest and square shoulders, draped in dark crimson robes. His face is like a statue, chiseled and weathered, bearing a fearsome grin. Ah, the young prince. How I have searched for you. Tell me, where is your brother? Where is the heir?
Sorry. I thought it was me.
The prince can't bring himself to lift his head. Every breath trembles with effort. We found him alone, Fireborn. We think the shadow spotted by the west gate was the heir, but he hasn't been seen since. Oh, it matters not. It is you I want, Oceanborn. Yes, your brother told you, did he not? I assume he saw the whole thing. Else, why would he flee with you the way he did? The Inquisitor approaches, the shadow of his shadow creeping closer. Listen to me very carefully. If your brother told you I want you dead, he was lying to you. What use would you be to me then? Indeed, I am the one chosen by God. I am the Fireborn, wielder of the infernal miracles. And you? You and I share a goal. I have no desire to take the lives of any of your family members unless they leave me no choice. No, the death I seek is that of Daisha. And you do too, do you not? What would your brother say were he here? He fought against Daisha. They have tried to invade us for decades now. Why, evil Dacian spirits destroyed Lakeford and started this whole war, didn't they? Didn't they? Ah. You see it, don't you? You didn't just have a vision. No, you summoned a great power. You made the earth open its maw. You destroyed Lakefort. The war started because of you. Don't you see? You and I are so alike. We both wield miracles. The only difference, my prince, is that you have no idea how to harness it. And that is no fault of yours. That is where I come in. As one chosen by God, it is being revealed to me through divine wisdom that you are my enemy. But it doesn't have to be this way. I know how to help you. The Church of Varna has a place just for you. Elazareth has a place just for you. I have a gift. Crown. Your crown. Not the crown of a king, but that of a mighty wielder of miracles. Accept this gift, sire. Release your potential place it upon your head. Feel the crown beckoning. The prince stares at the circlet offered to him. Two parallel bands with a dull shine, but otherwise featureless. Lakeford, his brother, Dacia. The prince watches as the circlet glows with allure. The war with Dacia is his fault. The Inquisitor is right. He must be right. Do I want to wear the crown? The prince accepts what is offered to him. The moment he makes contact, heat passes through him, rippling, coursing, leaving numbness in its wake. He raises it up and places it upon his head. The Inquisitor smiles, and everything is changed forever. He sees the storm again, but this vision is not like the others. The waves churn, the wind cuts, the thunder rolls, the storm is real. It is here. It is hellfire. Flames roar outward, filling the underground space in an instant. All is red, then white, blinding, searing. The prince screams and the fire roars back. And then darkness returns, and in the darkness, embers glow, cooked stone, scorched corpses. Everything choked with soot and ash. The prince gets up and looks for the Inquisitor. Is he dead? Did the firestorm take his life? But rising up with him is a great shadow. Though the zealots have been reduced to mere embers, another stands, towering, indomitable, fire-born. And the Inquisitor speaks and cinders fall from his mouth. My prince, come. We have much work to do.
Work? Man.
Oh, what a wonderful little city out there. I hope nothing bad will happen.
What a pretty little
oh,
view.
Oh, yeah.
Sometimes foreshadowing is quite obvious.
He truly is really pretty.
VR chat role plays are all work and all play.
That just sounds like work.
The prince and the Inquisitor stand on an old bridge atop a hill. In the valley below, lies Felton, painted orange and blue in the light of the setting sun. The sky is clear. All is quiet. Do you know why I brought you here? The Inquisitor sounds distracted, distant. The Prince does not know. He's losing track of his own thoughts. He's losing track of reason, of time. He thinks the other zealots are dead, but he isn't sure now. There was fire, lots of fire, and his mind aches. Something blocks his attempts. Something else is in there, in his mind. The Dustborn was right. You are the chosen one, granted influence upon this world like no other. Chosen by an enemy of the Church, an enemy of God, the very God who chose me and bestowed upon me the miracle of fire. We are both chosen. We are not so different. A task has been revealed to me. Felden has become infested with Dacians. But even before then, Felden deserved this judgment. The Inquisitor looks down at his own hands. He looks at them for a long while, his expression wavering somewhere between sadness and fury. Then he lifts his gaze up, up toward the heavens. The Prince looks up with him at the vast, deep, empty sky. Balswith, Halburn, Orodea, Medaius, Felden, may the heavens come down upon them, and may they be reduced to ashes.
Why is the sky red?
The sky, oh dear.
Is spicy now.
Why is it spicy?
The rushes up from the depths, rising to meet him. From up high, a massive expanse of land stretches out before him. Rivers are ribbons of silver, mountains are mounds of soil and stones, cities and towns are smudges of beige and grey, and the sea, a distant shimmer. Entire realms can fit within his grasp, and he reaches out and begins to close his hand around the kingdom. A face appears before a flickering candle. Eyes closed. Peaceful. Beautiful. Delicate. Porcelain white. And he watches her sleep. He watches her sleep. My friends, you have have a choice to make. The prince has the following options. Destroy, 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 destroy. You have 1 minute to discuss what he should do, starting now.
Such negativity.
I think we should destroy.
Got it.
Yeah, I think we should destroy.
Dance on their graves.
I'm gonna go with
say, wait. Distract.
Why don't we tell him no?
The only good bit of distraction right now. I say we go
why
destroy.
Why don't we just tell him to bugger off?
No.
Destroy.
Which would you like to choose?
Destroy, 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 and not build.
What is the second one?
I see where you're coming from, but like, I think it's just got to be
anti-build.
I think destroy would be a better option.
Destroy Q.
What about defying our
fate? The fourth destroy
no, no, no. Destroy to the power of four. Or destroy times
you are wrong, incorrect. We must destroy.
Yeah, I will bap you. Yeah, what does that do?
Oh, hey, look, that's green.
Destroy.
I think it lets us build a new city.
That corner
oh, okay,
over
there.
You should do that one.
Create new world.
Yeah,
the guy was saying attack at
the
window.
Yeah, Felton's kind of grimy. I think we can put like a nice car park in its place.
Yes.
Let's go with that.
Nice parking lot. Nice parking garage.
Yeah.
$5 for a parking spot.
Let's go. Great idea. High five.
I am calling upon. Valentine Stare, what does the prince do?
He will destroy.
Oh.
The prince nods. Destruction is the right choice.
No. We hereby sign the death warrant for 1,000 souls.
Well, there goes the idea for our parking garage.
No, it's not gone at all. You'll see.
My friend,
okay,
I ask your silence for this cutscene.
No. I didn't want this. I didn't want this. Yes, you did. No, I didn't. Yes. And brother wanted it as well. Divine justice for what they did to you. To us. Stop. Get out of my head. Please. They deserve this. This divine judgment delivered by you. Your vision. Your will. Please stop. Please. Stop. Give up. Let go. Give this miracle to me. You aren't using it. You're a failure. A waste of breath. A waste of everybody's time. The kingdom doesn't need you. Your family doesn't need you. Your brother doesn't need you. Nobody needs you. Nobody wants you. Everyone will be better off without you. Not even I want you. Let me go. You're lying. Brother is... He's here. He's here with me. We're traveling to the sacred land of Lutetia together. And Mother is here. And Father is here. And we're all here. Friends and travelers, welcome to the last ever neutral ending of The Prince. Well done.
Bravo.
Woo! You can only go downhill from here.
This is actually my first time seeing the neutral ending, so.
Upholding such destruction. Interesting. My friends, for those who are new here, there will be some announcements in a couple of minutes by Sheen. So please remain here while the tour guides realign our ether. If you'd like to take a group photo, please do so here and now. We tour guides will stand in a group and you can coordinate the photo around us. Where are... There's Rendizo. Where is Sheen? Sheen, come here.
The hell's texting?
A group photo, my friends. Gather around us, facing the middle of this distorted place.
Well, we have to take it here. Literally, 1984. Could take it anywhere.
Where do I go?
No, we cannot leave.
Short.
We cannot leave the prince now. He needs us.
Where is he? I don't see him.
Being blocked by Thrill King.
Trapped in a prison of our own decisions. I didn't
know. The prince is the friend we lost along the way.
There we go.
Where?
Him.
Everyone say horrible demise.
Are you ready? My friends, on the count of three, we will say something together to farewell this ending of The Prince. What do we say?
Destroy.
Destroy.
Photographers, are you ready?
No.
Yes.
I forgot. Photographers are always mute. My friends, on the count of three. One, two, three.
Oh man, that quote from good? Billy Mandy, okay. Fuck. God damn it. That's a really good quote.
You're welcome.
You're welcome.
Wait, did we have the same idea, Captain Fana?
Yeah, we did. Hell yeah, destroy us all! Destroy us all!
Destroy us all!
Yeah, I guess he's done.
I think we're done.
Destroy us all!
Yeah, I think so, yeah. I guess I actually need to do something. Okay, bye.
I'll instantly leave the world without Trajan's true form.
I still can't get over that being the neutral ending of all things.
How many people?
What? There's a neutral ending?
We wiped out
the entire... It's an entire...